There was a table set out under a tree in front of the house, and the March Hare and the Hatter were having tea at it. A dormouse was sitting between them, fast asleep, and the other two were using it as a cushion, resting their elbows on it and talking over its head. The table was a large one, but the three were all crowded together at one corner of it.
No room!
No room!
They cried out when they saw Alice coming.
There's plenty of room.
She sat down in a large armchair at one end of the table.
Have some wine,
said the March Hare in an encouraging tone. Alice looked all round the table, but there was nothing on it but tea.
I don't see any wine.
There isn't any.
Then it wasn't very civil of you to offer it.
It wasn't very civil of you to sit down without being invited.
I didn't know it was your table. It's laid for a great many more than three.
Your hair wants cutting,
said the Hatter. He had been looking at Alice for some time with great curiosity, and this was his first speech.
You should learn not to make personal remarks. It's very rude.
The Hatter opened his eyes very wide on hearing this, but all he said was,
Why is a raven like a writing desk?
I believe I can guess that.
Do you mean that you think you can find out the answer to it?
Exactly so.
Then you should say what you mean.
I do. At least I mean what I say. That's the same thing, you know.
Not the same thing a bit, said the Hatter. Why, you might just as well say that I see what I eat is the same thing as I eat what I see.
You might just as well say that I like what I get is the same thing as I get what I like.
You might just as well say,
added the Dormouse, which seemed to be talking in its sleep,
that I breathe when I sleep is the same thing as I sleep when I breathe.
It is the same thing with you,
said the Hatter. And here the conversation dropped, and the party sat silent for a minute, while Alice thought over all she could remember about ravens and writing desks, which wasn't much. The Hatter was the first to break the silence.
What day of the month is it?
He had taken his watch out of his pocket and was looking at it uneasily, shaking it every now and then and holding it to his ear. Alice considered a little and then said,
The fourth.
Oh, 2 days wrong. I told you butter wouldn't suit the works.
He looked angrily at the March Hare.
It was the best butter.
Yes, but some crumbs must have got in as well. You shouldn't have put it in with the bread knife.
Thank you.
March Hare took the watch and looked at it gloomily. Then he dipped it into his cup of tea and looked at it again. But he could think of nothing better to say than his first remark.
It was the best butter, you know.
Alice had been looking over his shoulder with some curiosity.
What a funny watch. It tells the day of the month and it doesn't tell what o'clock it is.
Why should it? Does your watch tell you what year it is?
Of course not. But that's because it stays the same year for such a long time together.
Which is just the case with mine.
Alice felt dreadfully puzzled.
I don't quite understand you.
The Dormouse is asleep again.